Okay, the name of this story is The Christmas Guest. It happened one day near December's end. Two neighbors called on an old friend. They found a shop so meager and lame, made gay with thousand boughs of green. And Conrad was sitting, his face ashine, when suddenly stopped as he stitched a twine, and he said, "Old friends, at dawn today, when the cock was crowing the night away, the Lord appeared in a dream to me and said, 'I'm coming your guest to be.' So I've been busy with feet astir, strewing my shop with branches of fir. The table is spread, the kettle is shined, and over the rafters the holly is twined. Now I'll wait for my Lord to appear and listen closely, so that I will hear his step as he nears my humble place. And I'll open the door and look upon his face." So his friends went home and left Conrad alone, for this was the happiest day he had known. For long since his family had passed away, and Conrad had spent many a sad Christmas day. But he knew with the Lord as his Christmas guest that this Christmas would be the dearest and best. So he listened with only joy in his heart, and with every sound he would rise with a start and look for the Lord to be at his door, like the vision that he had a few hours before. So he ran to the window after hearing a sound, but all he could see on the snow-covered ground was a shabby beggar whose shoes were torn and all of his clothes were ragged and worn. But Conrad was touched, and he went to the door and he said, "You know, your feet must be frozen and sore. I have some shoes in my shop for you and a coat that will keep you warmer too." So with grateful heart the man went away, but Conrad noticed the time of day and wondered what made the Lord so late and how much longer would he have to wait. When he heard a knock, he ran to the door, but it was only a stranger once more. A bent old lady with a shawl of black and a bundle of kindling piled on her back. She asked for only a place to rest, but that was reserved for Conrad's great guest. But her voice seemed to plead, "Don't send me away. Let me rest a while on this Christmas day." So Conrad brewed her a steaming cup and told her to sit at the table and sup. But after she left, he was filled with dismay, for he saw the hours were slipping away. The Lord hadn't come as he said that he would, and Conrad felt sure he had misunderstood. When out of the stillness he heard a cry, "Please help me, tell me, where am I?" So again he opened his friendly door and stood disappointed as twice before. It was only a child who had wandered away and was lost from her family on Christmas Day. Again, Conrad's heart was heavy, sad, but he knew he should make the little girl glad. So he called her in and he wiped her tears and quieted all of her childish fears. Then he led her back to her home once more, but as he entered his own darkened door, he knew the Lord was not coming today, for the hours of Christmas had passed away. So he went to his room, he knelt down to pray, and he said, "Dear Lord, why did you delay? What kept you from coming to call on me? For I wanted so much your face to see." When soft in the silence a voice he heard, "Lift up your head, for I kept my word. 3 times my shadow crossed your floor, and three times I came to your lonely door. I was the beggar with bruised, cold feet, and I was the woman that you gave something to eat. I was the child on the homeless street. Three times I knocked, three times I came in. Each time I found the warmth of a friend. Of all of the gifts, love is the best. And I was honored to be your Christmas guest.
Silent Night, page 278.